with a silent prayer. Please come. Mr. BB, our former president of our India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, quotes, "I am the best.
I am the best.
I can do it.
I can do it.
God always with me.
God always with me.
I am the winner.
I am the winner.
Today is my day.
Today is my day."
In this plan, we are going to discuss about the topic structure of C++ program. Before going to discuss the topic, first we know what we mean by software. A software is a collection of programs. There are two types of software. One is application software, another one for system software. An example of application software is Visual Basic. An example of system software is C++. A program is a set of instructions. Suppose you write one program, each and every lines are instructions. Instruction means command. The next one is C. The history of C program. C program was developed by Danny Sixey in the year 1980. C is a structure-oriented program or procedure-oriented program. The short form is POM. C tabs. In C programming, two tabs is available, one for data, another one for function. A data is a collection of information, but the function is returning only one value and also to store a set of statements. Next one is C++. The history of C++ program was developed by Bajan Shoshkar in the year 1983. C++ is an object-oriented programming. Generally, its start from is whole-reason approach that creates a partition memory area for both data and also function. Whole-reason approach that creates a partition memory area for both data and also function. That is your there are four types of available in C++. The first type is data. A data is a collection of information. The next one is function. The function returns only one value and also goes to any set of statement. But class. The class is a combination of data and also function. Next one is object. The object is a instance of class. This is the structure of our C++ program. The first line you must be writing C++ header file. Next one is class definition. Next one is member function definition. At last you write the main function. So C++ is a bottom up approach because you write the main function in bottom. The first line you write the header file. In this header file you store the input and the output statement. In C++, header file is has include iostream.h. Generally, has is denote the preprocessor. Include is a keyword, but the io stands for input and the output. The stream is a sequence of bytes. And extension of the header file is .h. The other one header file is has include courier.h. The courier stands for console input and the output. This header file is used to store the clear state and also get sequence. At last, another one header file is has include math.h. This is stored the mathematical function, for example, sine and cos. Next one is class declaration. Already we know what is a class. Class is a combination of data and also function. The class is a keyword. Next one you write the class name. The class name is user defined name. Next you write the private and also public. Private and public are access modifier. The access modifier is also known as visibility mode. The private access modifier is used to declare the data. But in public person's modifier is used to declare the data, and also you write the member person declaration and also member person definition. At the end of the plan, you must basically the semicolon. Next one is member person. Generally, the person is returning only one value, and also those who will be set up statement. There are two types of person, one for member person declaration and another one for member person definition. The member person declaration format is return type, person name in bracket, you basically the argument. The return type is below the mod or equal. Use the define name. You can write your own name also. Next, you specify the data type. What must be written in on float. Next one is you write the variable name. The variable name is user defined name. You can specify your own name also. But in member person definition, you are asked to specify the open brace, set of statement, also close brace. This person definition. The main person is used to access the public access modifier, but the public access modifier is used to access the primary and also main person. But the private access modifier is used to access the public only. This is, for example, I can get the one input and also display the one output. Okay, right? Suppose every single program, you first you write the as include IOS being dot page. This render page is used to store the input and also output. The input, how to get the input? Using cin statement. How to display the output? Using cout statement. The next line you write the class and also class or name. The class name is display. The first access modifier is primary. The primary access modifier is used to declare the data. Suppose my data is int A. The next access modifier is public. The public access modifier is to define the member person definition. How to write it? Member person definition void person name. Person name is this. Open page just to get the input data using cin statement. And also display the output C of double less than A. Close the function and also close the class. Just to specify the semicolon symbols. Next you write the main function in the bottom. Because the purpose is a bottom up approach. The class name is display. To create a one object, the object is D. The object is used to call the member function definition. So D dot person name is this, and also close the main function. This is our example. How to save this program? Just you click the file and save and type the file name .cpp. .cpp is a file extension. How to complete this program? You click the Ctrl plus F9 to check the any errors in your program. Okay. Next one is our practical example. C++, the window list will be available. File plus new. The blue color window is appear. You just retype your code. For example, on the first line is as include iostream.h. You just type your program. Save your program, file plus save. Type your file name .cpp. How to render our program? Ctrl plus F9. So there is no error. You just will type your input file, press enter, the output will be displayed. Output is also file. Okay, student, I think you know how to write the C++ program. Are you know? Okay, any questions? Secondly, string is a sequence of bytes. The byte is consist of 8 bits. Any other doubts?
How will the signal be pronounced?
The sorted key is controlled by state. Any error is occurring in your program or not, it's checking. Are you giving your doubt? Okay, any other doubts? Okay, no problem. So, in this class, what are the topics we will discuss? The history of C program, C can, definition of C, history of C++, definition of C++, how to write the C++ program. These are the topics we have discussed. In the C++ class, some of the top packets I discussed. This content is freely available on my website. My website name is www.resenningcpp.cyclone.com. And also, today's class, PPT is freely available in SlideShare website. You freely download. And also, today class video is sent to your WhatsApp number. You just read it and watch it. This is my mobile apps. It is freely available in Google Play Store. You just type RDSCPP. Just the mobile apps installed to your mobile. And also, you check it. And also, the mobile app apps, you are not over your mind. Because this, my website link is converted into Android QR code. You just scan your mobile, it directly go to my website. And also, if you have any doubts, you freely ask in Skype. My Skype name is sukumar.ganasegaran@gmail.com. Thank you, students.
In this e-learning website, I got the Creative Commons license, and also myself and my students have successfully completed 70 consultancy projects for website development within 4 years through ENY ULearn program. The total honorarium earned by them was a tune of Rs. 3.1 lakhs. The audiobook is freely available in cloud. The website name is soundcloud.com. The audiobook is a recorded book that can be played on a computer or mobile device. And also, the audiobook is one of the main tools for blind students. This is our college principal feedback. This is our staff members feedback. And also, my alumni parents feedback also. This is my student's feedback. This is my alumni student's feedback. Thank you, thank you, Anandana.